Hello everyone, hope you have seen the part first, the basics of filling the unique disability certificate. In this video, we are going to see hemophilia disability certification. As you already know, commonest hemophilia is hemophilia A. There is problem in coagulation due to factor 8 deficiency. So the persons with hemophilia, they will receive certificate. Few points to be noted from your side are family history. As you know, it's a X-linked, so males are the only sufferers. A routine physical examination and systemic examination to be done. Orthopedic examination, as the bleeding occurs in joints, muscles, there will be restriction of movement. So send first to the orthopedician to get their percentage. Baseline CBC, APTT and prothrombin time should be available. As you know, APTT will be prolonged in these cases. Factor 8 levels by a standard laboratory is extremely important, as this is the only thing that is going to give them actual percentage. Let's look at the UDID booklet grading of hemophilia. So disability score or percentage is given. Next is the factor activity in the blood. So you can see hemophilia A factor 8 activity. Usually the patients will bring the reports. If not, you request them. And less than 1% factor activity in blood will usually give them more than 40%. Third is the clinical severity, where you have spontaneous bleed or restriction of a joint movement. So orthopedic review is extremely important. If factor activity is more, it can add to orthopedic assessment and percentage can increase. Watch the next video where I have combined both hemophilia percentage and orthopedic percentage and calculated the final percentage. Thank you.